use and or view at your own risk. I wanted to address the recent HeartBleed Web Encryption Vulnerability and show you some ways you can help protect yourself. Now, the things I'm going to show you to do will not protect you until the web servers or the operating systems affected patch their systems. But it's generally a good thing to do. So if you're using Mozilla Firefox, click it, open it. Then under the menu bar, click Tools. Then Options. Once the Options menu is open, make sure Advanced is highlighted. And the subtab Certificates is clicked. Then click the button Validation and make sure both checkboxes are checked. You can simply click OK, OK on the Options menu, and close Firefox. If you're using Internet Explorer, open it. Go to the Tools button in the far top right hand corner, click it. Then select Internet Options. If all you have available to you is the menu bar, select Tools and then Options, or the command bar, Tools and then Internet Options. So once the Internet Options menu becomes available, make sure and select the Advanced tab and then scroll all the way down to the bottom and under the heading of Security, make sure four boxes are checked here. Check for Publisher Certificate Revocation, check for Server Certificate Revocation, check for Signatures, and do not save encrypted pages to disk. Make sure at least those four are checked. Select OK, and you can close Internet Explorer. If you're using Chrome, open it. And in the top right-hand corner, select the Customize and Control button. This will bring up your options menu for Chrome. And then go to Settings. That'll bring up your options menu for Chrome. Scroll down until you see Show Advanced Settings. Click it. And you'll want to make sure two boxes are checked here. One under Privacy, Enable Phishing and Malware Protection. Make sure that's checked. Scroll down. And under HTTPS and SSL, make sure check for Server Certificate Revocation. Now you can rehide the advanced options if you want to. And simply close Chrome out. For a more detailed explanation of this vulnerability, please click the link below. Thank you for watching.